Chris Birch.
My man, Mr. Haskins. What's up, everybody? We're joining you this afternoon. And you guys have much snow down there?
We got about 2 inches, but it's pouring down ice and rain now.
Yeah, we're supposed to get that in D.C. like tonight. And then tomorrow, there's supposed to be even more snow throughout the day. And it's like, good grief, man. Mm-hmm. But, you know, it is what it is, man.
That's right. So, I'm thankful.
I wanted to bring you on today, Chris, because, you know, my channel on YouTube here is all about inspiring, helping entrepreneurs, teaching from my life lessons, the mistakes I've made, the methods and procedures that I put in place to excel in business. And I thought with you announcing your summit coming up, I thought it would be great for my subscribers to have that opportunity to look into this foreclosure summit that you've put together. And I wanted to give you a chance just to speak briefly on it, but I wanted to ask some questions about basically what this summit will include. What are some of the topics that you and I can go over that they're going to learn by you know, watching this all day summit? And when are you doing it?
Yeah, Chris, it's an honor to talk to a true entrepreneur as yourself, my friend.
Thank you.
February 13th, going to be all day, 12 to 5 Eastern Standard. I'm trying to get my West Coast homies on here too, so I'm starting later in the day. All day, man. It's going to be the first time I'm doing one all day. I usually just do classes, but this foreclosure thing is so detailed that I'm not able to put it into like a master class. So I'm going to be teaching you how to locate this stuff. What do you do before you bid? Bidding etiquette. One of my biggest pet peeves is going to the auction, and as soon as the damn bid opens.
Yep. You got all these hands popping up.
What's wrong with you? Don't you know auction bidding etiquette? You wait. Anyway, I don't get this stuff.
It's the eager buyer, and as soon as the auctioneer announces the first price, the hand goes up, right?
Anyway, I can't change it, but we're gonna bidding etiquette.
Yeah. So let's get into it. I wanted to first ask you, this course is gonna cover a vast array of topics throughout the day, yep. And I know you had mentioned it starts out with locating the foreclosure.
Yep.
Can you speak a little bit on what you're going to be showing people that join this summit?
Yeah, man. So locating, if you don't know, which I didn't know, every foreclosure is public record. Every one of them. They have to announce it in the public. But the key is these, what word can I use to be politically correct? These forward-thinking attorneys sometimes don't put the foreclosure auctions and sheriff sales in the most widely publicated documents, if you will. So there are.
Yep. So I'm assuming what you're saying is they kind of tuck them into the little local community newspaper, because legally all they have to do is show the public that it's coming up. Right?
Crazy. You'd be surprised, Chris. You know, both of us been around. You know how this thing works. As a matter of fact, I know some guy around here, Troy Titus, went to jail doing that mess, you know, just putting them out in the penny savers, which is public record. I recorded it. Yep. So,
yeah. I remember, what was that little, I think they had it in your market too, the penny saver.
Yep.
Right?
That's it. 15. Right.
Yep.
Four pages.
Yeah, and it really all this whole book was just a bunch of coupons for all these retail stores. And then they had the long classified list. Yep.
Sick, Chris. So anyway, around here, around the Tidewater area, there's a couple of them, which I don't even know. And I'll show you how to Google it. You know, I mean, you can find them in any city. In some cities, it's just the sheriff's sale. It's like a big thing where you go down, where they do it once a month. So it all depends on where you're at. Every state's different.
Gotcha. Yeah, I think that would be great for a lot of our viewers to understand that it's not always in the big, you know, New York or the Washington Post, even though you will find them there as well sometimes.
Yeah,
you will. But You'll teach them a strategy of how to get behind the curtain, in a sense, to find these.
It's so weird, man. I was thinking, I remember back in the day listening to Robert Kiyosaki. It's all about where you shop. You know, do you go in the MLS, look for that stuff, or do you go? You can shop anywhere you want to. Do you go to Walmart, Target? Do you want to go to Macy's, Saks Fifth Ave? I mean, it's up to you.
No, that's true. I mean, I actually bought a foreclosure off the MLS. They listed it, you know? You can. Yeah, exactly. All right, so cool. And then you go into kind of how to not only find them there, but how to research the potential properties.
Yeah, you're going to, first of all, do we even know if it's something we want to buy? So we use prospering for that. But in the bigger picture, I had a friend in your market, Chris, that bid on a property, and little did he know. See, what a lot of people don't understand is a foreclosure is nothing but a sale. Mm-hmm. That's it. It's just a sale. Mm-hmm. So you got to make sure you know what lender is foreclosing, what position they are in. If you don't know that, man, you could really get put out of business.
Yeah, because as you know, in that document that you sign at the courthouse steps, it whatever your purchase price might not include any liens against the property, or, you know, there's a lot of little technical things that you have to read.
Might not. You're right, Chris. They're not going to give you the money back. Oh, I didn't know. You think they give a crap about not knowing?
Yeah. Yeah. And you brought up a good point. I'll add it to the video description. We got a link for PropStream. Chris and I use PropStream, every couple times a day, really.
That's right. You better.
And it was so accurate. I'll let you guys know that Chris and I recently did a deal down in his market, Hampton Roads Market. I searched PropStream a couple weeks after Chris and his partner acquired it, and PropStream was so up to date. It was like literally within the court system, and it showed all the data.
Yeah. It's cool. Cool.
Yeah. Yeah. So then you know, speaking of doing the research, you're also going over title as well, correct?
Yeah, I'm going to show everybody what a title search looks like, because I didn't know what the hell it was before, and show you what position these loans are in, because believe it or not, a second or a third mortgage can foreclose. I've had a second mortgage foreclose on me on one of the many houses that I've lost.
Wow.
So you got to know what you're doing.
Right. So now you're going to basically... In theory of how this summit is going to go through, you're going to take them to the courthouse steps and what they're going to need to do and tools that they're going to have in place before they get to the steps.
Yep.
But then also what they do when they get to the steps.
When you get there, bidding etiquette, how do you do it after you win? What do you do? What do you do? You got this contract here as a member. I'm going to show you what we get when we bid, a memorandum of sale, because they can't do a purchase and sale agreement because they don't own it yet. You know, they're just taking over for the lender.
Gotcha.
That memorandum. And how do we bid? What do you do with the money? How much money to put up? I mean, we don't buy them in our names, right? So you got to know how to transfer it. You bid in your name. You know, you're not bidding as an entity. You got to know how to bid, where, you know, there's so much stuff, man.
Correct. Yeah. I mean, even to the simplest things that I am unfortunately admitting to being a victim of as well, you better have your earnest money deposit with you.
Oh yeah.
Right.
Matter of fact, you can't even bid. Like the foreclosing trustee, they ask for the proof of funds before you can sign the paper to bid.
Yep.
They don't want to hear that. Like, you don't got no money. Okay. Step aside. You step aside.
Yep. I've been to foreclosures that weren't at the courthouse steps. They were at the steps of the property.
Uh-huh.
Right.
Same thing.
And I didn't bring earnest money with me because I was really just doing research. Man, I lost my shirt. I could have got such a good deal by simply not having. I lost the deal because I didn't have my certified check.
Just being prepared. You got to be prepared. That's all.
Yep. Yeah.
Now, a lot of it starts here, though, Chris. Mm-hmm. A lot of it, man. Like, am I going to be prepared? Luckily, I have a team. So Smitty can do a lot of this research for me. Well, with me, not for me, but with us. And he can look at a lot of that stuff.
Right.
So I can focus on the money part, which really works out well.
Yeah. Yeah. And now, in your opinion, who is this course going to be best for? Is it the savvy investor? Is it the someone who maybe has been in real estate but never done foreclosures?
A lot of those.
Okay.
I will say that, let me preface this by saying, if you are a new investor, You better not do any type of foreclosure auction bidding unless you know what you're doing.
Okay.
And even further, a lot of savvy investors been around 10, 15 years, never even been to the steps, you know? So I would say it's for the newbie and the seasoned guys, brother, because a lot of people don't, I don't know what drew me to the steps. I guess maybe going down there a million times doing research, looking for probates. I saw this dude standing outside. And where else in the world can you show up to a location and instant equity get created? You know, a borrower could owe $250,000 and then the opening bid be $150,000. I mean, they are making equity, creating equity out of thin air. It's just unbelievable to watch it happen.
Yeah. Yeah.
You've seen it. I mean, whatever. No doubt the one that you bid on, they didn't open it up with the total amount that the person owed.
No, I did my due diligence on that, even though I was unprepared when I got to the steps. They opened the house was probably worth probably about $225 to $250 in good condition, sellable condition. And they started the bid at like $10,000.
What did they owe?
About $116,000. When I had looked it up, but so that's a different scenario. And I guess your summit here is going to help people understand all of the different variables. I know you're going to talk about how do you handle a foreclosure if the house is occupied? How do you handle a foreclosure so this property that I was mentioning that I went to, it clearly stated in the foreclosure listing that there would be no walkthrough of the premises allowed. So that's why I honestly was going for research. When they said you can't walk it, I'm like, that's crazy. I'm not going to do that. I get there. The door's open. The trustee for the foreclosure was there and the auctioneer. And they said, oh, go ahead and walk around.
You got to be there, right?
There you go. You
got to be there. If you ain't there, I mean, that's the thing. I can't tell you. Matter of fact, I was going through my old videos. How many foreclosure houses have I visited just like that, just going to do recon, and the damn door be cracked open?
Yep.
You know, it's walking.
Exactly. We got someone on Facebook joining us, Chris, saying that they can't wait. Thanking you for doing this.
Well, here's the thing. I noticed being doing this since 2004. When I got in, it was like the market was going like this.
Mm-hmm.
And then it just, everybody knows what happened. My gut is just telling me this is where we're headed, Chris. You know, all the signs are there. So why not get prepared now to understand what's coming in the future? That's all.
Yeah, very true. And I was having this conversation with a fellow investor this past week, and he was saying that he thinks that the banks are going to be even more forgivable than they were before. Well, my response to his statement was, well, why wouldn't I prepare myself now if the banks are not going to be forgivable, right? Regardless if there's COVID relief or mortgage relief, there's still going to be more foreclosures because of the time frame. We're dealing with almost 12 months of the banks not being able to pursue or get into the court to start the foreclosure process.
Good Lord. You know what, Chris, I'm just thinking there's going to be a group of the population where that I think a lot of us are reassessing our lives right now. Mm-hmm. A lot of people are like, do I need this house? Why did I even buy this house? Do I want to even live here anymore? I mean, there's so many different subcategories of people that are going to reassess their lives. And some of these houses just not going to fit in the equation for them.
Yeah. I mean, I think a lot of people misconstrue what foreclosure actually is.
Yeah.
And the reason, and every reason is different. Foreclosure is not strictly someone defaulting on their mortgage. Yes, technically speaking, they have defaulted. But the reason they defaulted, there's a million reasons.
Oh, yeah. It could be a million things, man.
Yeah.
A million things.
Yeah. So, guys, the link below for Chris's summit. He's also, even in this one-day course, you're bringing on a real estate attorney. Is that correct?
Oh, yeah. My boy Bill Brunchick just happened to be a friend of mine. We connected years ago. I met him back in like 2005.
Okay.
And now that I'm a published author and, you know, I got a platform, we do a lot of stuff together. He's been doing it since the 1990s. He's going to come on and talk about the legal aspects and what happens after you buy it. And also do some training on redemption rights, because some states where the borrower has the ability to come back and cure that debt. And instead there, we have we have ways, as my friend Lou Brown says, we have ways around that.
Exactly. Exactly. And it's usually whoever beats the other one to the court first.
That's right.
Whoever gets the document filed correctly in first place. Yeah.
Got to get it done right.
Yeah. Cool. So you're doing this February 13th.
Yeah.
From noon to five.
Roughly that, I'm presuming. Okay. I don't know, but you can't judge how long these things will take. But yeah, I'm gonna have my boy Dutch on too. Gonna go over. Cool. I just decided that yesterday, kind of doing some pre-foreclosure stuff, showing people how to do the text messaging stuff. If you want to try to intervene before the foreclosure, I'll cover a little bit of that throughout the day too.
That text messaging and stuff that Dutch does is so key, because he's actually getting leads on pre-foreclosures that aren't even a pre-foreclosure.
Yeah, something.
He's starting to hear the pain points from the owners, right? Yeah. He's hearing it before the banks even know they're in default.
That's right.
Yeah.
Dutch is doing some amazing stuff.
Right. That is cool, man. So I'm not going to hold you too long. I just wanted to invite you on, share this, with my subscribers.
Yeah.
Continuing to grow, you say it all the time. You pour information into people. And that's my focus. I don't have any, there's no underlying objective. It's sharing information with people that like and also share our content. So, Chris, I'll leave you with that. But any final thoughts, anything special that they can look forward in this summit? I mean, it's going to be a wealth of information. I have it on there. The link, you can sign up for his 1-day summit. There's a link in the video description below.
Yep.
Closing points?
Yeah. Well, first of all, Chris, for you, man, I mean, just what you're doing, just a matter of time for you. Your channel just goes through the roof because of the information you're sharing.
Yeah.
Genuinely, the word I've learned recently, genuinely, altruistically. Now, I just learned that word. So bear with me if I'm trying to make sure I deploy it properly.
Mm-hmm.
When you give with not expecting anything in return, it's almost like the universe kind of just opens up the clouds and it just rains on you crazy. So thank you for doing this, Chris.
Yeah, man. And for years, I mean, I've heard people say, show me how to do this, show me how to do that. And I said, I can't focus sharing it with one person at a time. So I said, you know what? Let's do the internet. Let's do YouTube. Let's do Facebook. You guys can put questions in the comments below on this video. We're, happy to help, happy to share.
Yeah.
But also don't forget, give me a thumbs up on this video. Share the content. Subscribe to the channel if you wish. There's a lot of good information, both on Chris Haskins' channel as well as on mine. And Chris, you've already crossed the 70,000 subscribers, I believe.
It's crazy, Chris, man. I mean, even when I, every day is a new journey, it's a new contact, a new lead, a new this, a new that on this internet.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm just so looking forward to what 2021 has, my friend.
Yeah. Yeah. That's great, man. Cool, man. That's all I had. Thank you for joining me, guys. Click the link below if you want to get involved in Chris's summit, and we'll see you guys soon.
Foreclosures, instant equity. Instant equity. Just like this. I remember one time I saw a house that was a burnout. The opening bid was like 7,000. I mean, 17,000. So you just don't know what's going to happen.
You don't know.
You got to be there. You have to be there.
Yep. All right, man.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.